إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ربي وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, as we all know the benefits and the significance of fasting in Ramadan, and as it's one of the five pillars which is the roots for Muslims to follow. There are five pillars in Islam, the first which is the declaration of faith, which means that to believe there is no God worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Muhammad is his final messenger. The second one is the prayer. We the Muslims pray five times a day, and there is some flexibilities in prayer as well. If you are traveling, you can combine and share the prayer. If you are sick, you cannot stand, you can sit in the chair and pray. The third one is charity. We the Muslims give 2.5% from our saving money to the poor people. But if you don't have anything to give, then there is no charity from you. And the fourth one is the fasting, and this is what we are going to talk about today. Also in fasting, there is some flexibilities as well. If you are traveling and you think it's hard for you and it can harm yourself with fasting, then you can break off your fast and you make it another day other than Ramadan. If you are sick, you cannot fast, also you can break your fast. For the women, if she have the period, if she is pregnant, if she is sick, also she can break her fast. This is the flexibilities that Islam gives to us. It's easy as it is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. So the significance of fasting is the taqwa. And the taqwa is to follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants exactly from you and what the Prophet's command us to do. All you who believe, fasting is prescribed for you as it was prescribed for those before you, so that you might guard against evil. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith, and he said, كل عمل ابن آدم يضاعف الحسنة بعشر أمثالها إلى سبعمائة ضعف إلا الصيام فإنه لي وأنا أجزي به يدع شهوته وطعامه لأجلي للصائم فرحتان، فرحة عند فطره وفرحة عند لقاء ربه، والصوم جنة، فإن كان يوم صوم أحدكم فلا يرفث ولا يفسق، وإن أحد سابه أو قاتله فليقل إني امرؤ صائم والذي نفسي بيده لخلوف فم الصائم عند الله أطيب من ريح المسك. Every good deed of the son of Adam will multiply manifold. A good deed will be multiplied 10 times up to 700 times, as well as Allah wills. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, except for fasting, which is for me, and I shall reward for it. He gives up his desire and his food for my sake. The fasting person has two joys. One, when he breaks his fast, and the other one, when he meets his Lord. And the smell that comes from the mouth of the one who is fasting is better before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the smell of the misk. Allahu Akbar. So everything, every good actions, every good deeds we do, it increased 10 times up to 700 times. As Allah also mentioned in the Quran, and He said, مَنْ جَاءَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ فَلَهُ عَشْرُ أَمْثَالِهَا وَمَنْ جَاءَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ فَلَا يُجْزَى إِلَّا مِثْلَهَا وَهُمْ لَا يُظْلَمُونَ. Whomever bring a good deed, he shall have a 10 times like it. And whomever brings an evil deed, he shall be recompensed only with one like it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so merciful. But He kept the fasting for him, and the reward comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why the rewards comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the fasting other than the other good deeds? Like when you pray, you get rewards. If you do good deeds, you get rewards. If you give sadaqah, you get rewards. But when you are fasting, you get rewards, but you don't know how much rewards you get. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep it secret. So when we do the fast, we do it sincerely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the scholar says that the fasting, it is half of the patient. Because no one is targeting you to see if you are eating and drinking. You can eat anywhere. You can act like you are fasting, but when you are alone, you can eat. It's different than when you are praying. When you are praying, everybody is seeing you. If you are giving sadaqah, everybody sees you. But when you are fasting, this is between you and Allah. That's why the scholar says fasting is half of the patient. It teaches you how to behave. It teaches you how to act with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and with the good manners. And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give for those who are patient. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran. إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرُهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Only the patient will be paid back their reward in full without measure. That's why the scholar says, fasting is half. So Allah is rewarding you without measure. So it is something we cannot even imagine it. And another significance of fasting, it deletes all the previous sin that we have done. None of us have not done any sin in his life. We all do mistakes. We all do sin. We are not an angels saving from doing any sin or mistakes. But the Ramadan is the station for us to repent back to Allah. So we can fast and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala delete our sin according to the words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. الله أكبر. He who observed fasting during the month of Ramadan with faith while seeking its reward from Allah will have his best sins forgiven. It's a very good title for us. So we all do sin. So if we really need our sins to be removed and forgiven, we have to perfect our fasting. And it also teaches us how to behave with others. And when you are fasting, it is very important that you let or your body fasting as well. You let your tongue fasting. Don't start bite-biking about others and talking about others. And you start seeing the bad things, the Allah wafil things, then what is fasting is doing to you? How it's changing your behavior? Fasting shall change our behavior and shall make us more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَنْ لَمْ يَدْعَ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ والعمل به فليس لله حاجة أن يدع طعامه وشرابه. The Prophet says, if one does not avoid lies and false account conducts, Allah has no need that he shall abstain from his food and drinks. So it is very important that we should, when we talk something, we talk truthful and not to start talking about others in a bad way. And also in the hadith al-Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كل عمل ابن آدم له إلا الصوم فإنه لي وأنا أجزي به والصيام جنة فإن كان يوم أحدكم فلا يرفث ولا يسخط فإن سابه أحد أو قاتله فليقل إني صائم. And this is the important. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the hadith al-Qudsi, every act of son of Adam is for him. Whatever good deeds we do, it's reflecting us. You will see it thereafter in the day of judgment. Except fasting, which is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will reward him, the one who fasts. And fasting is a shield. When anyone of you is observing fasting, he shall neither glide in obscene language, nor shall be raising his voice. And if anyone reviles him or tries to quarrel with him, then he shall say, I'm a fasting. And this is the important thing. And this is the behavior what the fasting is teaching us. If this happened in another day other than Ramadan, I'm doubting that this will happen. So the importance of fasting is teach us how to behave with others, how to behave with our families, how to behave with ourselves. And Ramadan is going so fast, my dear brothers and sisters. It is as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَيَّامٍ مَعْدُودَاتٍ, for a certain number of days. It's 29, 30 days. And it's only happened 1 month a year. So we have 11 months. So why we do not put much effort in this Ramadan while we are fasting? And there are some flexibilities of fasting. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَىٰ سَفَرٍ فَعِدَّةٌ مِّنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ. The flexibilities in fasting, if you are traveling, you can break your fast. If you are sick, you also can break your fast. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرِ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرِ. Allah wants ease for you. He doesn't want to make it harsh and harmful to your health and to your body. My dear brothers and sisters, in Ramadan, there is a day which is called Laylatul Qadr. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أتاكم رمضان شهر مبارك فرض الله عز وجل عليكم صيامه تفتح فيه أبواب السماء وتغلق فيه أبواب الجحيم وتغل فيه مردة الشياطين لله فيه ليلة خير من ألف شهر فمن حرمها فقد حرم. The Messenger of Allah said, there has come to you Ramadan, a blessed month, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has enjoined you to fast. In it, gates of heaven are open and gates of hell are closed, and every devil is chained up. In it, Allah has a night which is better than 1,000 months. Whomever is deprived of its goodness, it's indeed deprived. So one day, one night equal to 1,000 months, which equal to 83 years and 4 months. So imagine you are standing in the front of Allah praying in this night, and you are reading Quran and you are doing whatever good actions, it will equal to 83 years and 4 months of rewards. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, the age of my nation, it's between 60 and 80, and some are exceeding. So you are doing double of your age maybe. And when you are standing in the night worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the scholar says, the best prayers after the required prayer by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet is the night prayer. Allah says in the Quran, كَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِّنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ وَبِالْأَسْحَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. They stay the whole night worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and when it's time for sahar, which is like 50 ayahs reading of Quran, that's the sahar time, like half hour or so before the adhan or the call to prayer. This is the sahar, and they sit and they start to make istighfar, forgiven, asking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They used to sleep but little in the night, and in the morning they ask forgiveness. And this is how we shall do it, especially in these days, the days of Ramadan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another verse, أَمَّنْ هُوَ قَانِتٌ آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ سَاجِدًا وَقَائِمًا يَحْذَرُ الْآخِرَةَ وَيَرْجُو رَحْمَةَ رَبِّهِ قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرُ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. He who is obtained during the hours of the night, posturing himself and standing, takes care of thereafter and hopes for the mercy of his Lord. Say, are those who know and those who do not know alike? Only the man of understanding are mindful. So when you are standing in the night, are you similar to the one who is sleeping? No way. Standing in the front of Allah, asking Him for any good things that comes to your mind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the last third of the night, He comes to the earth world, to the world life, and He asks, who is in need for anything in his life? Then I can help him. Who is in help? Then I can help him. So if you stand in the front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing is difficult for Him to forgive you. If you ask goodness for your child, for your family, for the whole ummah, then Allah will accept it according to the Quran. And according to the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Alaykum biqiyam al-layl, fainnahu da'bu al-salihin qablakum, wa huwa qurbatun lakum ila rabbikum, wa mukaffiratun lis-sayyi'at, wa munhatun 'anil-ithm." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned about the night prayer, and he said, hold fast for the night prayer, Qiyam al-Layl. For it's the practices of the righteous people before you. And indeed, Qiyam al-Layl, the night prayer, is a means of nearest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't we all need to be near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And a means of provision from sins. We all need the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we all need our sins to be deleted. An expiation for bad deeds. So it will neglect, it will delete all the bad deeds. And a barrier
for the body against diseases. So for those who are complaining about sickness, for those who are complaining with harshness with their heart, for those who are complaining about a lot of sins that they have committed in this life, you have the night prayer is the key to get all of these solved. And especially in Ramadan, it's more rewarded. And also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ فِي اللَّيْلِ لَسَاعَةً لَا يُوَافِقْهَا رَجُلٌ مُسْلِمٌ يَسْأَلَ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا مِنْ أَمْرَي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا أَعْطَاهُ إِيَّاهَا وَذَلِكَ كُلَّ لَيْلَةٍ. Allahu Akbar. There is an hour during the night in which no Muslims individual will ask Allah for good in his world, and the next without his giving it to him, and that applies to every night. So there is 1 hour, it's kept secret so we can stand and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is recommended for us, especially in Ramadan, you know, you don't want to sleep full. You don't want to go ahead and sleep when other people are doing good deeds. Take advantage of your time. No one knows that he will catch up the second Ramadan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us having many Ramadans. But it is very important, my dear brothers and sisters, to look at our actions and to see what is sure that we are doing, then we can make up in these days and the night of prayers. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also mentioned in the hadith, and he said, and this is a very beautiful hadith, من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Allahu Akbar. The Messenger of Allah said, he who observes optional prayer, which is Taraweeh, or the night prayer, throughout Ramadan, out of sincerity of faith, and in the hope of earning reward, will have his bad sins forgiven. So there is 2 hadith. If you fast the Ramadan with faith, Iman and Wahtisaba, and all your sins will be forgiven. And if you wake up in the night, all your sin will be forgiven. My dear brothers and sisters, it's very important that we need to do more actions. As it mentioned in a different hadith, مَا زَالَ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ. The night prayer is considered nawafil. Means it's an extra prayers or optional prayers. حَتَّى أُحِبَّ. Then until I love him. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you, you didn't need the helps of anyone else. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala satisfied with your actions, then this is the objective of this life. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala satisfied with our actions, then we will be satisfied here and thereafter. So I want to summarize the hadith and the verses of the Quran in 11 points. So maybe you can teach your child, you can teach your family, you can teach other with it. The first one is الصيام وقاية من النار. Fasting is protection from hellfire. So if you want yourself and your family to be protected from hellfire, then perfect your fasting. Obtain fasting. The second one, الصيام يشفع لصاحبه. Fasting intercede for the owner. The third one, خفاء أجر الصائم زيادة في الثواب وسعة في الرحمة. The concealment of the reward of the fasting people is an increase in reward and
obtains of mercies, of mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you get the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first one, الصيام يضاعف الحسنات ويكفر السيئات. Fasting, double good deeds and expedite evil deeds. الصيام عصمة من السقوط في الشهوات. Fasting is a break from feeling and desires. الصيام تغلق لأجله أبواب النار وتفتح أبواب الجنة وتقيد الشياطين. Fasting closes the door of fire and opens the door of paradise and chain the evil. الصيام زكاة الجسد ونصف الصبر. Fasting is zakah or charity in the body and half of the patience. الصيام يربي السلوك والأخلاق. Fasting, it teach us how to behave and how to have a better behavior. الصيام أحد عرى الإسلام وقواعده الثلاث. Fasting is one of the five pillars. التقوي من ثمرات الصيام. Piety is the fruit of fasting. And the last one, الصائم مستجاب الدعوة. The fasting person will have his call answered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who follow his commands and who follow the commands of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and who accept his fasting and the night prayer. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.